Hello, fucking ninjas. Welcome to my broadcast slash video. Going to continue the story of the archaeologian, Trumped. Alright, Quanquenard has some exciting news. Word of Lady Lefaire's, charity has begun spreading, my friend. I have attended more than one luncheon with, where it has positively dripped off the tongues of all the good lords and ladies. With knights, oh, the knights, they have started rumbling about why magics just not only heal the wounded, but also enhance the strength of the healthy, are not being employed to save the lives of those on the front lines. Needless to say, the Vault is not amused. Their plans to have us fade into obscurity has rebounded upon them. And now they are scrambling to twist this situation to their advantage. Listen, Kimiko, the vaults would have us officially attend an operation currently underway in the Western Highlands, village of Hamlock. The settlement was abandoned after the calamity and has since been overrun with beasts of all manner. The Holy See seeks to reclaim it, and my father has generously volunteered his knights to clear the area of any remaining threats. It is win-win for the Vault. The oppression is small enough and far enough away from the capital that even if it is a success, no one will pay it half a mind. But the Vault will be able to say that they answered the pleas of the knights. If for any reason the operation were to fail, then the Vault would be able to attribute the failure to the Australian presence and turn the High House against Lady Lefaire. I spoke with the lady about this, but she said she was not interested in the politics of the situation, only that it was her duty to aid people in need. We would speak haste to Hamlock. To Hamlock we go. Western Highlands? To the Western Highlands! Now, Jesus. That way. In the middle of nowhere. Here to help with the operation? Word has it that the battle has taken turns for the worse. I could have just flew there. Anyway. Hola, people. As I fly in on a dragon. We severely underestimated the strength of our enemy, and now my men and women have themselves overwhelmed. The tight wedges we had at the day's onset have all degraded into small knots of fighting. The numbers of wounded is growing faster than our camplains can heal them. Thank the fury you have arrived when you did. Where am I? Where is my company? I must return to them. I so forgot this, Australian. I am forever in your debt. Oh. Well, maybe you could, stop this motherfudger from attacking me. Don't forget this, Australian. I am forever in your debt. Turn that off. You have my thanks, but there must still be many who require Siklar. I heard a woman scream beyond this very boulder, not moments before you arrived. No. 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 Nah. What have we here? Sestavri? You who vowed never to set foot in the barbarian land again, unless... Clever girl, yes, it was I who hired Cecile to bring you back to Solarian. And if you had come back with us quietly, you would be free now. Right now, rather than a wanted criminal facing a trial, imprisonment, even execution, depending on what you have told these tamed savages of yours. Yes, my dear, I offered you a chance, and you foolishly refused it. The edict has been issued, and I am here to collect you. Though I must place some of the blame of what that on your friend Cecile, had she not insisted on playing games, perhaps you would have displaced reason back to the Black Shroud. Instead, she merely added fuel to the fire, already hot with your inherited stubbornness. And now I am forced to make the journey to this filthy realm to clean up her mess. And I suppose that starts with these companions of ours. Kimiko, take Quankunin and leave. Right now, whether neither of you are ready for magics of the variety he wields. But what of you, my lady? I am going to reclaim my father's journal. Brave. Your father was brave. Your father is also dead. Lady Lafifa. I now understand Cecile's frustration. This realm is truly overrun with vermin. Now we suffered here for so long, I will never know. Very well, Lafifa. You leave me no choice. You may already know we have questioned Professor Mace regarding your unauthorized passage into Eorzea. What you may not know is that we still hold him in the dark cells, just as a precautionary measure. Of course, we would not want to see him flee again before the trial. Now, your grandfather is not as spry as he used to be, and I am uncertain how long the sanity of a man of his age will last in complete darkness. Though the longer you delay, the closer we come to finding out. If you wish to see your grandfather released, you may come to the abandoned city in the Dalarian Hinterlands. There, my airship will be waiting to take you back to the old world, where you will be tried fairly, of course. I suppose you could run, but know that doing so would have grave consequences for your grandfather, and possibly your mother as well, and we would still eventually find you. Wait, my father's diary. He may still be close. Wait here. Leila Lafera, who was that? I have the strangest feeling I know should know him from somewhere. Stev, leader of the Bibliolatics, a powerful group of conservative fundamentalists who seek to control the whole of civilian knowledge. They believe that our people should not become involved in history, only be witness to it and analyze it until all the lives lived and lost are but numbers on that page. You may remember Sir Sturion Junicornard, because he was the self-famed man who pushed for old Solarians to batten its doors and abandon Eorzea, and used my father's death as his rally cry. And now I am certain that he was my father's killer, or he had my father killed. Nearly the end of my father's diary, he mentioned being contacted by a young Stavistier, I can't pronounce it properly, who happened to be a classmate of his when they were both at the studium. I'm just gonna call him Steve. Steve! Looked to make a name for himself as a politician, warned my father against continuing to desecrate knowledge of Solarians. Astrology in the Eorzea, a warning my father, of course, did not heed. Soon after, several attempts to were made upon my father's life. When he subsequently looked into the matter, he discovered that there was a price on his head, and that Steve had put it there. I discovered a contact signed by a wretch folded in my father's journal. He had planned on revealing it to the forum on his return, but he never had the chance. Conquenard, my father gave you that journal before he died, but you never once opened it? I did not think it was mine to read, but what you say, if it's true, we must get that diary back. Come, it seems the fighting has died down. Let us report to the captain of the knights and then return to Isgard so that we may plan our next move. Many lives are saved because of you. If this is what we can expect from Solarian Astrology, I see no reason why we shouldn't have knights trained in the field. I will recommend this to the Lord Commander. I suspect he will be pleased to see the day one with a few casualties. If you we require our services again, you need the only ask. Come, Kimiko, let us hasten back to Isgard. Back to the homestead. Back to the homestead! Back to the homestead! Back to the homestead! Oh! Ah! Ah! Moments ago, we received a massive from the commander of my father's guard. He thanked us again for our assistance in Hemlock and has formally requested that Lady Lafrana train several of his knights in the Solarian Astrology. The vault, however, remains silent, and I believe the silence is to be calculated if the edict issued for Lady Lafrana's extradition has arrived. They need only turn a blind eye to Steve's actions until he has spirited the lady from the realm. The people simply forgot she was ever here. But we are not going to let that happen, are we, my lady? I am sorry, Conquenant, but I no longer see how we cannot. Steve has my grandfather. He has threatened to take my mother, and he now has the one thing that could have saved them both, my father's journal. No, Conquenard, I cannot deny my fate any longer. I have done several readings since I returned, and everyone is the same. Deceit, manipulation, submission. My path is clear now. However, can carry on. Steve has no authority over you or you, Kimiko. See that my father's dream is fulfilled. Promise me that much. Quampler and I will see you to the place of meeting. Sir, that's not. Damn it. I actually present. You know that by attending me, you put yourself in danger. He has shown he will not hesitate to kill anyone who stands in his way. And now that he knows I know of his involvement in my father's death, but still, you would stand by my side in the last moments of Ezra. I do not deserve friends such as you. Himiko, Aether is the building block of all that surrounds us. meaning that everything is connected. Someone closely attuned with the ether can, and in a sense, link themselves with others, feeling their joy, feeling their pain. Scholars of the soul call this empathy. Crystal gazers and card readers call it the Wheel of Fortune. We Australians can call it collective unconsciousness. Whatever you call it, I feel that that bound with you, both of you. Thank you. Collective unconsciousness. Complete. Yeah. Alright, I should probably put that up here. Let's change this. Any other moves that involve attacking? Essentially that do to you. Alright, that ends this portion of my broadcast slash video. I'm going to end it here, and thank you for watching. If you enjoyed my content, give me a follow and on Twitch and Twitter, and if also subscribe to my YouTube channel, all under Ninja Master Funk. Yeah, thank you for watching, and I'll catch you guys later. Peace, and stay funky.